Alrighty, everybody. Got my hand. I got my pan heated up. I got some water heating up. Don't need it to boil. Gonna have some hot chocolate and just got a little baggie here of salt pork. Seen Derek from the Woodsman School use salt pork. He called it bacon on steroids, so that sounded good to me. So kind of do what he did for his I don't know if it was for a breakfast or a dinner, but he did salt pork and some kind of corn muffin mix. I'm gonna do that. So bacon and cornmeal mix. Kind of a frontier type food. We got, yeah, let's go with, go one more. Fill the pan up, right? Might as well. And actually, I've only got one more piece left, so little munch for later. So we'll let that cook up, and we'll be right back. Everybody, the salt pork is definitely getting there. Give me some good oil in my pan for my I think it's about time I should start mixing that up. It's all it is Martha White yellow cornmeal mix. Y'all can see that. Mix it up in a bag. A little water. Bacon on steroids is almost done. So no measuring, it's just all by eyeball. Maybe just a little bit more. Definitely had a good night out, but yeah, so we'll just put it in a plastic baggie, and when it's mixed up, I'll just cut the end off of it and use it as one of those cake decorator things. Just squeeze it out. that one needs another minute or two there. There. So let me get the bacon out of here and get my muffin mix mixed up, and we'll return. Alrighty guys, we are we're back. We got our muffin mix in our bag here. We're just gonna squeeze it out. More out there. Let's get it cut it down here, kind of flatten it out. Make it kind of look like something there. So we'll let this go and all that good stuff, and when this gets cooked up, we'll have some breakfast. So don't know how long this is gonna take, actually. Kind of, I don't know. Not real thick, kind of pancakey. Haven't used this stuff, so as long as it don't stick to my pan here, it shouldn't. Had that bacon grease in there, so we should be good there. So yeah, so let me get this cooked up, and we'll be back. Hey everybody, I got it done. Didn't the corn muffin mix kind of crumbled on me, but I guess need to. I'm gonna do that next time. I need to figure out what the ratio is on that, but corn muffin crumbles, yeah, be okay. I'm going to be doing the Land O'Lakes Chocolate Supreme today. Get that going. The French vanilla was real good, so I imagine their chocolate supreme is going to be just as good. Change it up a little bit. Yeah, I kind of moved up here. It's just easier doing it up on that side today. So you got my. this is what Derek Farrell made on his Frontier cooking. He went with coffee, I'm going with hot chocolate. Not a coffee kind of guy. Have he used some sort of fancy maple syrup. I'm just gonna use good old Aunt Jemima syrup. Always airplanes. Let the airplane go overhead. Excuse the airplane. Sorry. Style syrup. Aunt Jemima, and why not? He did add a little bit into the hot chocolate as well. Get that back and stir. I took this water off soon enough so I can have a drink. But cheers, guys. Good morning. Perfect. Just, yeah, perfect temperature. So let's try this bacon on steroids, the salt pork. Definitely salty. Not a problem. The corn muffin mix, a little bit of syrup on it. Edible, without a doubt. The old frontiersman definitely could get this down to a science, without a doubt. See how the crummy part is. I got done, so alrighty, let me get my breakfast done, get everything cleaned up cooking wise, and break down camp so I can get home and get this video up by tonight. So we'll be right back, guys. Fly. Alrighty, that was an interesting meal, without a doubt. Always a first for everything. Salt pork is definitely bacon on steroids. could get hooked on it. Be careful. My cornmeal mix didn't, it was good, all crumbly, but it, I guess I didn't have the right mixture. But I'll leave a link below in the description to Derek's video on his Frontier cooking on when he did it, so you can see the right way of how it comes out. Edible, you know, it all goes to the same place. So, and the Supreme hot chocolate, definitely a hit. I think the next one is Arctic White or White Arctic, I think. Gonna give that a try. But yeah, flies are starting to come around now, so. Alright, as I said, I'll leave a link below. If you guys don't know Derek, he's another one of the great guys. He's an instructor for the Pathfinder School, as well as he's got his own school. So you're getting definitely twice the knowledge out of Derek. So go check out the Woodsman's Ways and Derek Ferrer. And yeah, let me get cleaned up here, and we'll be back. Alrighty, like in this morning, I get to put out another, well, not put it out, but make sure the fire's out. Another, probably dump another two of these on here at least, and I got one more to put back at my campsite, just one more time for that, and just to make sure all my my fire hot spots are definitely cold. So let me go fill it up a few more times, dump it on that. Get one more and dump it on my one I had last night. Just gotta make sure, take it the extra precaution. I have the access to the water anyway. So there's no excuse for me not to make sure that this fire is totally out. Let me go get some more water. Stay tuned. All right, everybody. Now comes the time all of us campers, hikers, whatever you want to call us, end of our time, we have to pack up and go home to our loved ones. Love to stay out here longer, but we got to break this down and get home. So I'll probably edit and cut some bits and pieces out of this out of here. Just gonna break the rest of it down. I got my roll mat and my tarp, basically, to take out, and that's it. That's easy. We're going with minimum gear, less to pack up. I guess that's a plus. So, alrighty, let me get to it. Like I said, I'll chop bits and pieces of this one out. So, there we go. I'll just leave the prussic knots on the rope as it is, so they're there when I set up either my 5x7 tarp or my 8x10 tarp. The Fresic loops will already be on it, so. Well, that's it, guys. When you're doing minimal gear, you don't have much to pack away. Only thing left to do is just tighten up my Alice pack, untie it from the tree, put my mat on top, and we're out of here. So this is this is where my fire was. It is definitely out. So leave no trace, as always. Never known I was here. Only in the history books. So. Alrighty. As I said, I had cut some bits and pieces out of this part of the video. So. Let me get the rest of this. Well, let me get my Alice pack down and get it on my back, and we'll head out of here. Be right back. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. I got it all cleaned up. As always, leave no trace. Make sure all your fire hot spots are definitely out. See behind me there, pretty good. That's where I was at. Can't even tell I was there. That's the way it's supposed to be. So let me track on out of here and get to editing this video. And what else? I don't know. Gotta double check, make sure I got everything here. It's not that far to the truck, but far enough that I don't want to walk back again. Yeah, so that's everything. Yeah. Appreciate your views, your comments, and any suggestions that you have. Leave them in the comments below. Check out the couple shout outs I gave out. Mr. Chris Kane Survival over there in the UK. Excellent, great, fun guy, just all around knowledgeable. And Derek at the Woodsman School. Chocked full of knowledge. A lot of good resources, so if you don't know those two guys, definitely click on the links below and check them out. So, alrighty guys, until the next video, y'all stay safe out there, alrighty? Thanks for watching.